डिटेल वर्जन और रिटन ब्रीफ वर्जन बट नॉट इन एन एलोबरेट वे. ओके तो लेट मी जस्ट स्टार्ट. या तो फोटोसिंथेसिस दिस इज काइंड ऑफ वन ऑफ द बेसिक प्रोसेसेस adapted by some of the living creatures on the earth, not just plants, many living creatures. Like as I mentioned earlier, there are many microorganisms which has chloroplast in them and they can do photosynthesis. Okay, so we have phytoplankton, we have zooplankton, and we have cyanobacteria, we have algae. All of these tend to perform photosynthesis. Okay, so coming to the photosynthesis, this is a kind of a process which actually see the conversion of energy formats, like one format of energy can be converted to another form of energy. Okay, so you have actually seen a lot of examples. Like you see, when you for example take a motorbike or take a so-called car, okay, we usually put gas. So when you actually put gas or when you actually put petrol, this petrol is something that is actually getting converted into, so like it is giving the energy format in the petrol is getting converted into mechanical format of energy, because of which you tend to see some kinetics happening with the vehicle. So the vehicle moves. Okay, same way you look at the most of the locomotive engines in the railway stations. Nowadays we have like advanced locomotive engines which utilize so-called electrical sources of energy. So there the electrical sources of energy is converted into so-called mechanical, and the so-called transition happens. So the most important step here is transition, conversion of one format of energy to another format of energy. Okay, so if you're going to look at the solar panels, nowadays we are relying on them for more of like to establish more of eco-friendly states, right? So especially with respect to power generation issues, where we want to cut down on the so-called conventional electricity, people are coming out with solar based panels, right? So solar panel has this cell called as photovoltaic cell, which actually can convert solar form of energy into so called electrical form of energy. All right, similarly the nature also has a kind of a transition. Already we have a lot of transitions happening in nature, and this is like one of the best transitions which we can actually study. So here, what is the transition? It's conversion of photic form of energy or the solar form of energy into chemical format of energy. Okay, so how does this happen basically, and why it is so important? It is very important. It is very important on the earth, because if you're going to look at the oxygen production on the earth, we already have, like, it earth took a lot of time to come up with oxygen on its atmosphere, right? And after the oxygen has advanced, then we have many other creatures which started to evolve. Okay, and the life on the earth has been beautiful, right? But as the life evolved on the earth, there are certain living formats which actually can liberate oxygen, and that's through this process called as photosynthesis. Okay, and photosynthesis do contribute to a huge amount of oxygen on the earth. That's one thing. And second thing, if we are going to look at the food, as I said earlier, we have certain creatures which actually can make their own food. In terms of so-called sugar production. Okay, so we call them as autotrophs. Okay, because sugar tends to be one of the most important sources of energy. Like if you're going to look at the energy formats, probably like 80% of the energy formats or energy deposits usually come from your sugars. Okay, and carbohydrates. Okay, so apart from carbohydrates, we have proteins and fats also contributing to energy, but highest energy contribution usually will be coming from carbohydrates. So where does the carbohydrate production takes place? So it usually takes place in so-called these photosynthetic creatures. Or you have another kind of autotrophs called as chemoautotrophs, which are usually anaerobic. You find them in so many layers below the earth, okay, doing a lot of chemical activity. So what do they do? They rely on the chemical sources, and using the chemical sources, they make their food. So that's chemoautotrophism. Those are usually exhibited by some of the microbes or bacteria available in those layers of the earth, and they are anaerobic in nature. But if you are going to look at the majority of the creatures on the earth, majority of them are aerobic in nature. And for aerobic creatures, you have two categories. One are producers and the other one are consumers. Okay, so producers usually tends to be these microorganisms or the plants which actually bear the so-called chloroplast during the process called as photosynthesis. Okay, and they can synthesize their own food, and we call them as autotrophic creatures, because the creation of the energy or so-called generation of sugar molecules is dependent upon the light, and hence we call it as photoautotrophism. Okay, so photoautotrophism marks the beginning of a food chain. Kya hota hai? Last time when we have actually looked at the potential format of energy, the transport begins with so-called photons to the plants, from producers to primary consumers, which are nothing but your herbivores, and from primary consumers it goes to secondary consumers like most of the carnivores, then omnivores, and this way you have many other consumers dependent upon these consumers, and finally they end up with decomposition or the retrievores. Okay, so this entire pathway has multiple channels. It's kind of a flowchart, and you call it as a food web or a food chain. Okay, so the beginning of the food chain will be with photosynthesis, and not just that, the water cycle, the rain cycle on the earth is dependent upon this. Okay, because we are also regulating carbon dioxide here, and carbon dioxide has a huge role in condensation and evaporation processes. Okay, so at the same time, carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas, so all the creatures which usually perform photosynthesis do consume a good amount of carbon dioxide from the nature, reducing its levels. Okay, and this is again enhancing something called as the healthy ecosystem. At the same time, this also do take part in the so-called generation of a good rainfall. Okay, so this way photosynthesis has lot many significances in the nature. Okay, so how does the photosynthesis happen? Where does this basically take place? Okay, we have actually come across a term called as chloroplast. Chloroplast. Where did we hear this term?
Plant cells.
Yeah, when we were actually studying cell structure, during the time when we want to make out the differences between the plant and the animal cell, this is one of the common differences. Okay, we do have exceptions. Apart from that, if you are going to look at the common differences, chloroplast is one of the difference between the plant and the animal cell. Okay, so chloroplast. So this is a kind of a structure that actually performs photosynthesis. Okay, this is like one of the cause for the so-called this is the structure that is basically acting as your transistor, or you can say. Okay, so what does this chloroplast contain? If you're going to look at its ultra structure of the chloroplast, you have lot many components. Okay, you can see this layer is the outermost membrane. It is a double membrane structure. So you have outer membrane, you have inner membrane, in between you have some space. This space is called as intermembrane spaces. Okay, and in the inner membrane you have this fluid filled viscous liquid. This viscous liquid is called as stroma. Okay, and you can see these bunches here, over here. So these bunches usually are made up of the complex structures, membranous structures called as thylakoids. So these thylakoids instead of being single, they are arranged in the group. Okay, so a group of thylakoids or a stack of thylakoids is called as granum. Granum, granum. Now this granum tends to get connected to other granum, forming a complex of grana. So how do they connect? They connect by these bridges. These bridges are called as lamellae. Okay, so what all do we have in the chloroplast? We have outer membrane, we have inner membrane, we have membrane spaces, we have this fluid, viscous fluid called as stroma. This is just like your cytoplasm. Okay, so we have this stroma, and in this stroma you have these stacks being arranged with several connections are called as lamellae, and these stacks are called as granum. In a granum, an independent component is called as thylakoid, which is membranous in nature, and this granum tends to get in the format of a complex together called as grana. Okay, so this is how a ultrastructure of a chloroplast look like. This diagram is very important, you guys have to practice it. Okay, so in this thylakoids in this couplex structure, as I said earlier, when you are enlarging it, if you're going to look at this membrane, in the membrane, you have these pigments available everywhere. This pigment is called as chlorophyll. Okay, this pigment is called as a chlorophyll. This is basically a hydrophobic compound that you usually find in the membrane, and this is the one which where the so-called the absorption of the light happens. Okay, absorption of light. This is again something related to light mechanics. Like when light is incident on any surface, you usually tend to see three phenomena. One is absorption. Two is transmission. Three is reflection. Okay, transmission, refraction. दोनों अलग है या सेम है? Refraction and transmission are both same or are they different?
Different.
Different.
How they are different? See, refraction is nothing but
the path of the light ray doesn't changes, but in refraction the path changes.
But that's a phenomenon of transmission only. Okay, when a light is incident on a surface, and if the surface have a refractive index, where the light actually has to take a bend, the phenomenon is called as refraction. It's basically a kind of a transmission only, but the light is deviating from its original path. That's called refraction. That's a phenomenon of transmission only. Okay, so transmission, refraction, dono same hai. Don't get confused. Okay, reflection. What about reflection? रिफ्लेक्शन क्या होता है? रिफ्लेक्शन में तो लाइट पास थ्रू हो रहा है, फाइन, लाइट इज पासिंग थ्रू एंड इट्स मूविंग आउट. व्हाट अबाउट रिफ्लेक्शन?
व्हेन द कंप्लीट रे इज रिफ्लेक्टेड बैक.
या इट डजंट पास थ्रू बेसिकली, बट इट रिवर्ट्स बैक. इट टेक्स अ यू टर्न, यू कैन से यू टर्न एंड इट फ्लैशेस बैक. दैट्स कॉल्ड एज रिफ्लेक्शन. ओके, एंड the other phenomenon is absorption. So absorption means the compound or the incident surface is basically taking some part of photons. Okay, and these photons are being utilized for some other work. That's called absorption. Okay, so we have three different phenomena with respect to the light incidenting on a surface. So if you consider the chloroplast as a surface, on the chlorophyll also we have three different phenomena happening. We have a reflection, we have absorption, and we have transmission. Okay, so tell me, what are all the different sun rays that actually reach the earth? Matlab universe se we get a lot of rays. We get like cosmic rays, where we have gamma rays and all, right? We have visible UV, infrared, etc., etc. So out of all of these rays, what are the different rays that reach earth surface? Not the superficial layers, to the core, मतलब ground level तक क्या क्या rays धरती तक छू सकता है? Come on, this is very simple question, very basic question. Now we are all able to see objects around us.
Visible light.
This is visible light. Fantastic, very good. Majority of the light that hits the earth is visible light. Okay, and partly we get some UV, partly we get some IR. Partly, it's not, it's negligible compared to visible light. This is totally negligible. UV and IR are negligible. Okay, so now let's look at this visible light. So what are all the different colors that you usually have in visible light? We have 7 colors, right? 7 rang hai. Can you all mention what are these colors?
Vibrio.
Very good. Expand.
violet, blue, green, yellow, orange, red.
Very good. So we have VIBGYOR. Okay, fine. So which of these has the highest wavelength and which of these has the lowest wavelength?
Red highest and violet lowest.
Very good. And now we have understood which has the highest wavelength and which has the lowest wavelength. Fine. Now coming to the energy formats, which photons has the highest energy? Is it from the red light or is it from the violet light? Energy किसमें ज्यादा है, violet में या red में?
Violet.
So the energy is inversely proportional to the wavelength, and hence the photons of violet have highest energy and the photons of red has the lowest energy. Good. So these are the basic concepts. So when these photons from different wavelengths hits chloroplast and reaches the so-called chlorophyll surfaces, at the chlorophyll surfaces we observe three different phenomena: absorption, reflection, transmission. Okay, so absorption, let's begin with absorption. We have two different wavelengths being absorbed because of the functional groups that are available on the so-called chlorophyll. So these functional groups, one of the functional groups will be absorbing a region from blue and another functional group will be absorbing the photons from red region. So what are the two colors that actually tends to get absorbed? Red and blue regions gets absorbed. Okay, so absorption phenomenon red or blue mein ho raha hai, which means that hamara jo photosynthesis process hai uske liye energy kahan se mil raha hai? Photic energy, that's actually coming from the photons of red and photons of blue. Okay, so these two gets absorbed, fine. This is scenario number one. Now incidence number two, when the light is incident, one of the rays gets reflected back and that's green color. Okay, so the color green gets reflected back. So the reflected color is something that is usually captured by the eyes. Okay, hamara jo eye ka jo sensors hai, we can't capture the absorbed lights, we can't capture the transmitted light, but we will be able to capture the reflected formats of light. We will be able to visualize them. Okay, so what is this color that is actually getting reflected? It's green. So now you must have understood why most of the plants look greenish in color, right? Not just plants.
Sir,
we have when a light is incident on a surface, we have three different phenomena: absorption, reflection, transmission. Absorption, red and blue gets absorbed. Green gets reflected. The reflected colors are the colors which are usually captured by a eye. Okay, eye matlab, it can be a eye of an insect, it can be eye of a human being, a bird, a snake, anything. Okay, so like again, it depends upon the so-called creature you're actually looking at, because certain creatures are colorblind and certain creatures have more pixels compared to us, more pixel absorbing density compared to us. Okay, so with respect to human, we actually can capture the different colors, especially all the colors of FGR. So when the reflection phenomenon is happening, this is what we actually will be able to see, and that's the reason why you tend to see most of the plants to be greenish in color. Okay, why? Because chlorophyll is able to reflect green color only. Okay, and same way, let's say in your classroom, let's say we have Soham. Okay, let's say Soham's so-called if you're going to look at his letter, we are actually looking at white and we are actually looking at a indigo portion. Okay, so which means to say that the so-called the kind of the what do you say, paper that he has used, or the kind of the so-called incidences that are available to this particular region are actually able to so-called reflect the so-called indigo region. At the same time, you see the P in white, which means it's basically reflecting everything backward. Okay, so whenever you come across different colors in different so-called objects, you have to remember that it's basically the reflection phenomenon. Okay, jitna bhi pigments use kar rahe hain, like kapde mein bahut sare pigments use karte hain, each and every pigment has its own absorption phenomenon, reflection phenomenon. So the reflection phenomenon basically gives us more coloration. Okay, you tend to look at flowers also are like you tend to get lot many colors from the flowers. So all of these colors are basically nothing but the reflection phenomenon that you observe from the pigments that are available within them. Okay, so chloroplast is a kind of a plastic that has chlorophyll. The chlorophyll reflects green, and that's the reason why you tend to see majority of the photosynthetic regions to be greenish in color. Okay, that's one thing. And coming to the transmission phenomenon, what are the colors which are left over now? Red ho gaya hai, blue ho gaya hai, green ho gaya hai. Aur kya colors bacha hai?
Blue, orange.
Now blue ho gaya hai. Blue ho gaya hai. Blue,
orange, color. Yellow.
Okay, orange, yellow, aur
indigo, violet.
Indigo, violet. Yes, white, indigo, yellow, orange. VIYO are the regions which are left behind. So these gets transmitted. So these gets transmitted. So these are the basic phenomena that basically happens on the so-called chlorophyll. Remember absorption, red and blue, green is reflected, VIYO is transmitted. Okay, you can get a MCQ either in your internal or either in your end semester examination. Okay, now moving ahead with this process of photosynthesis. So when lights hit the so-called chlorophyll and when the photons are absorbed, we have the photons being utilized, but the utilization is restricted to a certain region of the chlorophyll. And where is that region? That's nothing but this green colored stack structure called as granum. So in the granum, you have a reaction running in the presence of photons, okay, or initiated by the photons, and you call this entire reactions as light reactions. Okay, so light reactions say humko kuch product milta hai, and these products are carried forward into the stroma, and in the stroma, in the absence of light, these products are being utilized to generate your sugar molecules, and these reactions are called as dark reactions. So as mentioned here, you can see, so the sunlight is being coming out, you have a red region, you have a blue region. We have different photosystems. You have complexes. You have complexes called as photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. So both the complexes basically will be utilizing the so-called photic energy, and this photic energy will be now used up to so-called split up the water molecules. Okay, the first and foremost reaction is hydrolysis. Okay, so light reaction mein kya hota hai? Aapka water molecule jo hai, उसका जो कोवेलेंट इंट्रैक्शन है, दे आर बीन डिस्टर्ब यूजिंग दिस फोटिक एनर्जी. सो द प्राइमरी रिएक्शन दैट बेसिकली टेक्स प्लेस इज हाइड्रोलिसिस. ओके, सो द वाटर इज बीन स्प्लिट एंड दिस विल बी लिबरेटिंग ऑक्सीजन आउटवर्ड. सो द फर्स्ट रिएक्शन इटसेल्फ इज गिविंग यू द ऑक्सीजन आउटसाइड. ओके, पहले ही रिएक्शन में आपको ऑक्सीजन बाहर की तरह आ रहा है. एंड वॉटर वी लेफ्ट ओवर विद, वी आर लेफ्ट ओवर विद हाइड्रोजन्स. सो दीज हाइड्रोजन्स आर बीन यूटिलाइज्ड at two different regions. At one region, we have a reduction been happening where a cofactor called as NADP will be converted to NADPH. Okay, and in the other case, you have some of the protons moving into the so-called intermembrane areas, and in these intermembrane areas, you see that we have a molecular motor which will be rotating based on this proton forces. Okay, but the proton forces Q, but because you have accumulation of protons at this region, and these accumulation generate a force called as proton motive force. Okay, coming out because of only hydrogen ions, and these hydrogen ions keeps moving this rotor, and this mechanical movement ho raha hai na yahan pe, so you have a rotation been happening. This movement will be enough to couple up a phosphate to another phosphate. Okay, and this is where the nature has utilized the coupling reaction of adenosine diphosphate to a phosphate, creating adenosine triphosphate. Okay, so this entire thing happens in the membrane of your thylakoid, and the output is actually happening in the stroma. So in stroma kya ho raha hai, aapka ATP nikal raha hai. Okay, so this is one of the most important reactions that is coming through the light. Matlab ye beech mein bahut sare pathways hota hai, we are not going to read any of them, we are not going to see how blue light is acting, we are not going to see how red light is acting. We just remember bluntly that the photons are being utilized to split the water molecule. Hydrolysis hota hai, hydrolysis hone ke baad oxygen liberate hota hai, protons ka istemal kiya jayega. Kahan pe kiya jayega? One, we have a reduction reaction happening where you tend to see the production of NADPH, and other you tend to see the production of ATP because of a proton motive force established in the intermembrane complexes known as ADP synthesis, and these rotors will enable the coupling of ADP to phosphate, resulting in formation of ATP. So this is happening, the so-called release of ATP is happening in the stroma. Okay, so this is what you have to remember. So if you're going to look at the photosynthetic reaction, light reaction, okay, these reactions are called as light reactions. All the photosystems and breaking and reduction and energy generation till here, the reactions are called as light reactions because they are completely dependent on light. So if you're going to look at the light reactions, 8 photons are being utilized to break 2 water molecules, for which 3 ADP is converted to 3 ATP, 2 NADP is converted to 2 NADPH, and we are getting oxygen as a important product here. Okay, so oxygen gets liberated, we get 3 ATP, we get 2 NADPH. Once again, let me repeat, for every 8 photons, 8, this is supposed to be written as 8 HNU, but I'm writing it as 8 HV. So HV stands for photons. For every 8 photons, 2 water molecules are split or hydrolyzed, for which 3 ADP and 2 NADP gets converted to 3 ATP and 2 NADPH, and you have a liberation of oxygen. So this is what happens in the light phases in the entire granum. Okay, now we are done with light reactions. Let's move on to the light independent reactions. So here you don't have any utilization of photic energy or the photons, and hence you call all of these reactions as light independent reactions. So light independent reactions mein yahan se jo bhi humko product nikal raha hai uska hum istemal kar raha hai, and you have a cycle running through, and this cycle will be having two ways. One is the regeneration way and the other one is a bypass way. So in the bypass way, we tend to get glucose. Okay, so this entire pathway or this entire dark reactions were discovered by a scientist named Melvin Calvin, and hence we can call it also as Calvin cycle. Okay, so ye stroma mein jitna bhi reactions ho raha hai, yahan pe jitna bhi reactions ho raha hai, okay, these reactions, where is this, yeah, so these particular reactions, yeah, these particular reactions are not dependent upon the photons, and hence we can call it as light independent reactions. You can also call it as dark reactions, or you can also call it as Calvin cycle. Okay, so how does the Calvin cycle begin? The Calvin cycle begins with the carbon fixation first. Now here in the second part, now we are utilizing the carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide ka role yahan pe hai. Okay, so now we are using the carbon dioxide, and this is being fixed onto a 5 carbon sugar called as ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate. Okay, this sugar is kind of a ribose isomer called as ribulose, which basically bears 2 phosphates on it, and these 2 phosphates are located at 2 different locations, as you can see in the next see this structure. So ye sugar ka structure hai, aur yahan pe aapka 2 phosphate hai. 2 phosphate agar ek sath hota hai to hum biphosphate keh sakte hain, lekin ye ek sath nahi hai. One is located here and the other one is located here, so it's they are available on 2 different regions, and hence you have to call them as bis, not bi. Okay, so we have this ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate. Now this ribulose 1,5 phosphate will be getting fixed up one more carbon, and where is this one more carbon coming from? That's coming from the atmosphere in the form of carbon dioxide. So we take this carbon dioxide and then we try to fix it in this molecule, creating a 6 carbon intermediate molecule. Now the 6 carbon intermediate molecule is being split, and how does the split happens? We again do hydrolysis. Okay, and through this we are actually going to get a 3 carbon acid called as phosphoglyceric acid. See, we have a ketone here. Okay, and now this takes a split. Once we add a carbon, we get one more ketone, and this both of these are now getting converted into acids. Okay, so this conversion is the first step. Okay, the stage is called as carbon fixation, where we get an acid, 3 carbon based sugar called as phosphoglyceric acid. Now this phosphoglyceric acid, uses a lot of energy which is generated from the light reactions, and you have a reduction reaction happening. Okay, so we have utilization of ATP, you have utilization of NADP, and you have a reduction reaction happening where you basically remove the oxygen. Okay, so you have an oxygen here, and from this oxygen now we are not we are getting an aldehyde. We have removed it, and this way we have a reduction reaction happening. So can you mention what is reduction? Reduction kya hota hai? What type of reaction is it? You have studied about oxidation and reduction reactions. Don't get into too complex chemistry. I'm just asking you basic stuff. Removal of what?
Oxygen.
Yes, removal of oxygen or addition of
hydrogen.
Simple. As simple as that. So what did we do here? We have actually eliminated this oxygen outside, and we are resulting it. मतलब acid से हमको aldehyde मिल रहा है. And this step is like a reduction step. Okay, so glyceric acid अभी क्या हो गया है? Aldehyde बन गया है. Okay, glyceric acid is now getting converted to aldehyde, and hence this is a reduction step. Okay, you don't have to remember the structures, just remember the titles, the name of the compound. Okay, so ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate, carbon fixation, we get phosphoglyceric acid. From phosphoglyceric acid, we get glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Okay, now this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate can get interconverted, but it can take part in two different pathways. One pathway is the regeneration pathway, which eventually will be giving you the same product, which is the reactant itself. Okay, which is nothing but your ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate. So here regeneration step hai, and there is one more pathway where you tend to see that we utilize more carbon dioxide, more of water, and we tend to generate the glucose. We are not going detail by detail. We just are bluntly deviating the path and producing the glucose. Okay, so this is a bypass pathway where you have one of the molecules. Like we have like 6 molecules of these being generated. Out of six molecules. 5 molecules move for regeneration, and 1 molecule will be moving out for so called generation of a glucose. Okay, so this way, if you are going to look at the dark reactions, the dark reaction goes this way: for every 6 carbon dioxide, for every 6 water, for every 18 ATP, for every 12 NADPH, we are generating a sugar. This is the only important compound that we are getting, and these are nothing but the so-called dephosphorylated or the so-called oxidized content of the same of these things, ATP. So this usually tends to get cancelled up. Okay, so light reaction क्या हुआ है? 8 photon का इस्तेमाल किया गया है हमने. Let me just. Okay, we have time. So लाइट रिएक्शन में क्या हो रहा है? 8 फोटॉन का इस्तेमाल करके 2 वाटर को हम ब्रेक डाउन कर रहे हैं, जिसकी वजह से हमको ऑक्सीजन 3 एटीपी 2 एनएडीपीएच मिल रहा है. अभी डार्क रिएक्शन में क्या कर रहे हैं? हम 6 कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड और 6 वाटर को एक्स्ट्रा इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं, एंड 18 एटीपी एंड 12 एनएडीपीएच आर ऑल्सो यूज टू मेक 1 शुगर. नाउ वेयर आर दिस एटीपी एंड एनएडीपीएच कमिंग अप फ्रॉम? दे आर अगेन कमिंग अप फ्रॉम दिस रिएक्शंस, लाइट रिएक्शन. तो हमको 18 एटीपी और 12 एनएडीपीएच पाने के लिए यहाँ पे कितना लाइट रिएक्शन होना चाहिए? अभी बता दिए, वी आर गेटिंग 3 एटीपी एंड 2 एनएडीपीएच फ्रॉम वन रिएक्शन. वी वांट 18 एटीपी एंड 12 एनएडीपीएच, व्हिच मींस हाउ मेनी नंबर ऑफ लाइट रिएक्शन शुड हैपन?
6
स्टेट ट्रांजिशन, वेरी गुड, 6. ओके, सो 6 लाइट रिएक्शन विल लीड टू फॉर्मेशन ऑफ 18 एटीपी एंड 12 एनएडीपीएच, व्हिच आर यूज्ड अप इन द डार्क रिएक्शन टू मेक ए शुगर. एज सिंपल एज दैट. Okay, so 6 light reactions, which means kitna photons ka istemal hoga?
48.
Kitna water molecules ka istemal hoga?
12.
Okay, see, so the same thing I'm mentioning here, 48 photons, 12 water molecules from light reaction. This ADP ATP component is completely cancelled up, okay, because they are being utilized, and again the same products are coming out. Okay, so 48 photons, 12 H2O, 6 O2 from light have been placed represented here, and from the dark, what extra are we using up? We are using up carbon dioxide, we are using water again, and what are the product we are going to get? We are going to get sugar. Okay, so if you are going to look at the net reaction of the photosynthesis, 48 photons, 12 water molecules from light, 6 water molecules from dark, totally 18 water molecules, 6 carbon dioxide are used up to generate one sugar, C6H12O6, this is glucose, plus we get 6 oxygen molecules. This is the final output of the photosynthesis. Okay, so your basic reactions that we have actually studied in your school days is now changed. Okay, so yahan pe humko kya add karna chahiye? What do we have to use here now? 6CO2, 6H2O, fine. What else extra do we have to use here?
48 HP.
48 photons, 48 HP, and 12 H2O.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's how the reaction is now changed. And this is your final reaction, okay? This is your final reaction. So in the entire Canville cycle, as I said earlier, you don't have to remember all of these chemical structures. No, not required. You just remember these names and you just remember this so-called steps. Carbon fixation next step, reduction next step, then regeneration next step. And remember the name of these compounds. You need to remember 1, 2, 3, and this one, 4. ये चारों का नाम, ये फोर्थ वन इज योर
ग्लूकोस. सो प्लीज रिपीट वंस अगेन.
इन दिस एंटायर साइकिल यू डोंट हैव टू रिमेंबर ऑल दी स्ट्रक्चर्स, यू जस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर द नेम्स ऑफ सर्टेन कंपाउंड्स. द फर्स्ट कंपाउंड नेम इज दिस वन, राइबोस 15 बिस्फोस्फेट. द सेकंड कंपाउंड नेम इज फॉस्फोग्लिसरिक एसिड और ग्लिसरेट. द थर्ड कंपाउंड नेम इज ग्लिसरालडिहाइड 3-फॉस्फेट एंड द फोर्थ वन विल बी योर ग्लूकोस. ओके, ओनली दीस थिंग्स, दीस व्हाट डू यू से, names you have to remember, and you have to remember the steps. Number 1 is carbon fixation, number 2 is so-called reduction, number 3 is regeneration, and number 4 is generation of sugar. Okay, only these four things, you just remember four so-called compound names and 4 step names. That's it. You don't have to remember the entire pathway. Okay, and you don't have to remember the enzymes also. Okay, so this is all about photosynthesis. And now you must have understood a little bit compared to your school days, a little bit advanced, right? Thoda bahut hum advancement kar chuke hain, because we want to study it with respect to the so-called energy utilization aspects and all. So now you must have got a bit more clear idea about photosynthesis. Okay, it's not like completely, because we haven't studied step by step, detail by detail, photons kaise transition kar raha hai, kya hai, wo sab hum dekhe nahi hai. Okay, at the same time, bypass pathway mein kya kya steps hai, wo sab hum dekhe nahi hai. So we have just brushed through. Okay, kind of a briefing have been done. Okay, so this is all about photosynthesis. In case if anyone has any doubts, you can ask me. In case if anyone has any doubts, you can ask me. No doubts? Fine. Thank you all. We'll meet again in the next class.
Thank you, sir.
Bye, everyone. You can all disperse.